Five philosophers sit together at the same table, each with their favorite plate of spaghetti meatballs in front of them. They can be in one of two states, either eating or thinking. Between each plate is a fork. These hungry philosophers can't wait to feast on their meal, but there is a catch. This is a special kind of spaghetti which has to be eaten with two forks at the same time. If they can pick up both the left and right forks, they eat. If not, they sit there and ponder upon life like the good philosopher they are. This might be a simple problem on the surface. However, there are some constraints. Firstly, when a philosopher is eating, no other philosopher can take the two forks being used. Secondly, they can only pick up one fork at a time. Lastly, these philosophers do not know when others may want to eat or think. So, how do you design a system to fulfill all of these criteria? Welcome to the Dining Philosopher's Problem, a core example problem in concurrent computing. Here, the philosophers actually refer to different processors running on your computer. And these multiple processors are requesting the same resources concurrently, the forks. So, let's start by tackling the first constraint, preventing two philosophers from using the same fork. We can design something known as a semaphore. A semaphore consists of two components, an integer counter and a thread queue. These components have special properties that help us deal with synchronization. We attach a semaphore for each resource on the table, in other words, one semaphore for each fork. The integer counter represents the number of shared resources currently available. For each fork, the integer counter's minimum value is 0, and the maximum value is 1, since only one philosopher can use it at any given time. The queue keeps track of the order in which the philosophers have requested for the resource. Now, we no longer allow the philosophers to interact directly with the forks. Instead, they are made to interact with the 5 semaphores, representing the 5 forks. They can perform two operations on the semaphores, wait and signal. When a philosopher wants to obtain a particular fork, they call wait on that fork's semaphore. Wait has two parts. If the semaphore has the value 0, the philosopher is blocked and added to the semaphore's thread queue. If the semaphore has value greater than 0, we decrement its value by 1, and the philosopher is granted access to the requested fork. When a philosopher wishes to give up a fork, they call signal on the fork's semaphore. If there were any blocked philosophers in the semaphore queue, one of them is unblocked and scheduled to act in the future. If no philosophers are in the queue, the semaphore value is incremented by 1. Note that these wait and signal operations are atomic in nature, which means that when the operation is in progress, no philosopher can interrupt it halfway. Now, we can start by designing a simple solution to let the philosophers eat. Assume every philosopher has an index from 0 to 4 inclusive. Each philosopher will execute this procedure as follows. In an infinite for loop, the philosopher starts from the thinking state. He attempts to pick up the left fork, then the right, then eats once he has both. After the philosopher is done, he releases the left fork, then the right, and the cycle repeats. Seems to work, right? Except it doesn't. For simplicity, say the table represents a single-core CPU, with the 5 philosophers representing 5 processors scheduled to run one at a time in some arbitrary order. Imagine the case where philosopher 0 starts by picking up his left fork. But before he can pick up his right fork, a series of events happen. Philosopher 1, 2, 3, and 4 are scheduled to act and pick up their left forks before their right fork. Now, when Philosopher 0 tries to pick up his right fork, we realize it is impossible as it is held by Philosopher 1. Oh dear, all the philosophers seem stuck due to the same problem. Nobody is able to obtain two forks, and their procedure does not include giving up forks before they are done eating. None of the philosophers can eat, resulting in a phenomenon known as deadlock. Deadlocks occur when these four conditions are present. 1. Mutual exclusion. 2. Hold and wait, also known as resource holding. 3. no preemption, and 4. Circular weight. In this case, mutual exclusion comes from the fact that a fork cannot be accessed by two philosophers at the same time. Hold and wait, because the philosopher holds on to the left fork while waiting to pick up the right one. No preemption, meaning no other entity can ask a philosopher to release a fork he is currently holding. Finally, circular wait, which is a cyclic dependency caused by all philosophers waiting for their right forks. So, how do you avoid deadlocks? By removing any one of the four conditions. One solution is to artificially limit the number of philosophers who can sit at the table at the same time. Instead of 5 philosophers, we will cap it at 4 using a counter semaphore so that eventually a philosopher is guaranteed to pick up both forks and eat. This removes the possibility of a deadlock by tackling cyclic weights. You might be thinking, doesn't this defeat the point of the original problem? And you are exactly right. If we want 5 philosophers to be present at the same time, we might want to consider another approach. Asymmetric solutions do just that. The most straightforward asymmetric solution is to just make one of the philosophers take the right fork first instead of the left one. Here, we can make philosopher 4 do just that. Alternatively, we could also make every odd philosopher pick up the left fork first, and every even philosopher pick up the right fork first. These solutions are simple to implement, but overlook a potential problem: starvation. It describes the situation where a process, in this case, a philosopher, is constantly unable to use a resource. The philosopher is continuously denied the use of the forks and literally starves as he cannot eat. This is where we can use the Chandy Misra solution. The forks now have two additional states, dirty or clean. Initially, all the forks are dirty. Say we have a pair of philosophers, P0 and P1, who both want to eat and need the fork. As a rule, we will always initially allocate any contested fork to the philosopher with a lower ID. Between P0 and P1, P0 has a lower ID, so he holds the fork. P1 has a lower ID than 2, so P1 holds it, and so on. Between P4 and P0, P0 holds the fork and now is the only one who possesses 2 of them, while P4 has none. Cool! We also introduce a new feature for the philosophers where they can request the forks they need to eat if they are not in their possession. When a philosopher is preparing to eat and attempts to pick up forks, he first requests any forks that he doesn't have from his neighboring philosophers. In this case, P3 is missing one fork, so he sends a request to P2. However, here's the catch. A philosopher who receives a request message will keep the fork if it is clean, but give it up if it is dirty. Furthermore, they must clean the fork before sending it over. In this case, since P2 has a dirty fork, he cleans and sends it, and P3 gets a clean fork. As we can see, this rule prevents forks from being re-requested immediately. For example, even if P2 tries to request for the fork again after passing it to P3, P2 will not get the fork since P3 holds a clean one. The rule states that a philosopher will not give up a clean fork, preventing a back-and-forth scenario where P2 and P3 keep passing the forks around. The request by P2 will be deferred, where P2 will get the fork he wants only after it is dirty again. Amazing! Now, P3 has 2 forks. Anytime a philosopher has both forks, the philosopher can eat and all incoming requests are deferred as well. Upon finishing the meal, the forks will become dirty, which allows for other philosophers to take the forks. Remember the deferred request from P2? Now, since the forks are dirty again, P2 can get the fork. Since P2 wants to eat, he will also send a request to P1, who has the dirty fork. In this case, since P1 is simply waiting, he cleans it and gives P2 a clean fork. And now, with 2 forks, Philosopher 2 can happily enjoy his meal. In summary, we have looked at various types of solutions, from asymmetric ones to break cyclic weights, to Chandy Misra, which is a better solution that even prevents starvation. Now, every time you come across concurrency in computer systems, just remember how you fixed the Dining Philosopher's problem and kept our Greek ancestors satisfied.